Hello everyone, I'm Bahrom and welcome. Welcome to the fourth part. In this part, I'll show you a very easy way of detecting the tenses of the sentences. What do I mean with that? When it comes to speaking, many students think of the sentence in their native language, right? First, they think the sentence in their native language and then they try to translate it into English. And yes, it is very important. Before saying something in English, you must know which tense to use, right? So you must be aware of which tense to use. And sometimes it is difficult to find the tense of the sentence. It's difficult to decide which tense you should use to make that sentence. In this part, I will offer you a solution to this problem. And of course, the solution is in this table. Let's get started. Let me show you how you are going to find the exact tense of the sentence. Let's begin with the example sentence. I was going to school. I was going to school. Suppose you make this sentence in your native language. Imagine you write it in your language and you want to say it in English. Let's imagine. We have to do this through English because I don't know your language. I don't know what language you speak. And if I knew your language, I would write the sentence in your language. But I have no choice but to introduce the system through English sentence. We have to do this through English. I hope you get me right. Okay, imagine we write a simple sentence in your native language, but we don't know. Or you don't know which tense to use. To find the tense of the sentence, to determine the tense of the sentence, you need to ask three questions. You should ask yourself three questions. And the first question is, what is the time of the sentence? What is the time of the sentence that you want to make? What do I mean with the time? As I mentioned in the previous lessons, we have three different time periods, right? We have present, past, and future. So, the sentence, is it in present or in past, future? Which one? And of course, the answer will be one of these three. What is the time of this sentence? It is past, right? It is past. So, we put the tick in the past box. The answer will be one of these three. It is past. Now we can move on to the second question. The second question is about perfect. Is there a perfect in this sentence? Does this sentence include perfect characteristics? I know the perfect tenses are difficult, but if you don't know the characteristics of the perfect, if you don't know them well, it will be difficult to determine whether it exists in your sentence. That's why I suggest you to study the characteristics or the features of this verb tense well. Study it in your own language. And the basic definition of the present perfect tense in the textbooks is this. If you want to describe a past action that is related to the present, you should use present perfect. So, is it enough? No, of course, it is not enough. Definition is not enough itself. Briefly, study its characteristics. In this sentence, there is no perfect, so we skip this box. We will not put any tick or cross. We just pass. Okay, let's move on to the next question, the last question. The third question is there continuity in the sentence? Does the sentence contain continuous? Have a look at the sentence. Does this sentence include continuity? Is there continuity in the sentence? You can find out whether there is continuity in the sentence by focusing on its meaning, right? If you look at the meaning, if you can comprehend it, you can easily find out whether there is continuity in the sentence. And yes, there is continuity in the sentence. So we tick the continuous box. We put a tick into the continuous box. If you look at the table, it says what the tense of this sentence is. The tense of the sentence is past continuous. It is the past continuous, right? If it was written in your native language, you would have known that you need to make this sentence in the past continuous. With the help of these three easy questions, you can easily find the tense of the sentence you want to make. All you have to do is just ask yourself these three questions. Write down some sentence in your own language and ask these three questions. This table will give you the exact tense of your sentence. Okay, let's move on to the next example sentence. I have gone to school. I have gone to school. Time. What is the time of the sentence? It's obvious. It's present, right? It is present. It's not past or future. I know some of you may say that it is past, or some of you may confuse about this, but try to think of these questions as simply as you can. Make it simple. Don't think too deeply. Present. Okay? So is there a perfect in the sentence? Yes, there is perfect in the sentence. How? This sentence has perfect characteristics. The sentence includes the characteristics of the perfect. I wish I knew your native language and could explain it. Why? Why do we have the characteristics of perfect? To solve this problem, you should try to establish a connection between your native language and English. Try to make a connection by using these three questions. There is perfect in the sentence. So we put a tick. All right. What about continuous? Nope, we don't have continuous here. There is no continuity in the sentence. The tense of the sentence is present perfect. Okay, next example. I went to school. I went to school. Time. It is past, right? It is past. Perfect. No, there is no perfect in this sentence. Continuous. No, there is no continuity in the sentence. So the tense of the sentence is past simple. Next. I have been going to school. I have been going to school. By the way, these are not complete sentence. I know, I'm aware of that. These sentences are not complete. I'm just trying to show you the parts that I find important. I have been going to school. This sentence is not complete, but it is enough to understand the main idea of this method. It's not a big deal. Okay, time. What's the time of the sentence? It is present, right? It is present. Perfect? Yes, there is perfect. This sentence includes the characteristics of perfect. Continuous? Yes, there is continuity in the sentence. If you look at the table, it says the tense of this sentence. It is present, perfect, continuous. If you want to find the tense of any sentence, just focus on the verb. Just focus on the verb of that sentence. And this sentence is in the present, perfect, continuous. Imagine you wrote this sentence in your own language and you found out that the tense of this sentence is present perfect continuous. Okay, let's move on to the next example. I had gone to school. I had gone to school. Another unfinished sentence, but it's not a problem. It's not a problem to detect its tense. We have verbs here. Time. What's the time? It is past, right? It is past. Perfect? Yes, there is perfect. Continuous? No. There is no continuity. There is no continuity in the sentence. That's why we don't have continuous. The tense of the sentence is past perfect. It is the past perfect. Okay, next. I had been going to school. I had been going to school. Again, unfinished sentence. Time, it is past, right? I had been going to school. It is in the past. Past. What about perfect? Yes, there is perfect. We have perfect characteristics in this sentence. We put a tick. Continuous? Yes, we have continuity. We have continuous here. The tense of the sentence is past perfect continuous. Past perfect continuous. All right. Seventh example. I will be going to school. I will be going to school. Time. Have a look at the time. It is future, right? Future. Not past. Not present. It is future. Perfect? No, there is no perfect. What about continuous? Yes, we have continuous here. The sentence includes continuity. The tense of the sentence is future continuous. Imagine you wrote this sentence in your own language and you asked these three questions and you found out that you should make this sentence in the future continuous. Okay. I will have been going to school. Next example sentence. I will have been going to school. It is future and it has perfect and it has continuous. Future perfect continuous. Okay. I am going to school. I am going to school. Time? It is present. Right? It is present. What about perfect? No, we don't have perfect. Continuous? Yes, we do have continuous here. It has continuity. The tense of the sentence is present continuous. And the last example, I will have gone to school. I will have gone to school. Time? It is future. You can see that we have a future formula here, will, right? Will. As I said before, just focus on the verbs of the sentence. Just focus on the verbs. It will tell you the tense of the sentence. It is future here. What about perfect? Do we have perfect? Yes, we have perfect here. And continuous? No, we don't have continuity. The tense of the sentence is future perfect. Future perfect. And in the next following lessons, I'll show you how you are going to make a sentence in these verb tenses. You can determine the tense of the sentence by asking these three questions over the table. Look at the table and ask these three questions. Briefly, write a sentence in your native language. Ask these three questions. Answer them properly. If you can answer these three questions properly, you will detect, you will find the tense of your sentence. You can write thousands types of sentence in your own language. I challenge you to write anything in your own language. Write down anything and ask these three questions. I bet you will find the tense of your sentence. And change your sentence and do it as many times as you can. In the future, you will not be asking these three questions to yourself to determine the tense of your sentence. You will not need them because you will comprehend the main idea of this system. You think of a sentence in your own language and you will be able to say that, okay, I need to make this sentence in present perfect continuous or past perfect continuous, future perfect continuous, etc. Okay, in the next part, I will show you how to make a sentence in English after you detect the tense of your sentence. In this part, we learn how to detect the tense of the sentence. But in the next part, I will show you how to make a sentence in English after you detect the tense of your sentence. All right, I'll see you in the next part.